Why do we do the things we do when it hurts you? I'll never understand why. We're at a place in our lives where we're tired of all the lies and the pain we feel inside. We want to make it right. I have nothing else to give except my life. Please accept this offering. I present my body, my sacrifice, holy. Ever want to take advantage of your grace and the sacrifice you've made. I gotta make it right. I have nothing else to give except my life. Oh, please accept my offering. I present my body, my sacrifice, holy.
the end of the day, he loves me. At the end of the day, at the end of the day, he loves me. Everybody say, say.
At the end of the day, at the end of the day, he loves me. At the end of the day, at the end of the day, he loves me.
You ought to close your eyes and sing that till you believe it.
At the end of the day, at the end of the day, he loves me.
Singing it till you believe it. Say, at the end of the day.
At the end of the day.
Let's go.
At the end of the day, he loves me.
Sing at the end of the day.
At the end of the day, at the end of the day.
Put your hands in the air.
He loves me.
Sing at the end of the day.
At the end of the day, at the end of the day.
Here we go.
He loves me.
Sometimes I cry, think of all the pain that I've caused you inside. I don't mean to be emotional, it makes me cry. Think of all the pain I've caused you inside, but you still. Think of all the pain that I've caused you inside. Don't mean to be emotional. Anybody got this testimony? But sometimes I cry when I think back over the pain that I caused you. But you ought to just, when that thing hits your spirit, you ought to think about how ratchet and crazy and stupid you used to be. But at the end of the day, at the end of the day, he loved me through. At the end of the day, at the end of the day, he loved me. So don't mean to get emotional. But if I have to, I'll cry. Think of all the pain. Caused him inside. Lift your hands and say, do you still?
So how he talks with me, yeah. So how he tells me that I am his own.
Everyone,
Welcome to Jesus Love Bible Assembly International. My name is Brother Justin Farrell. I want to greet you all in the precious and wonderful name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Welcome all the family members and all well-wishers and everyone else that came to the homecoming service of two wonderful people. Hallelujah, Jesus. We bless your name. While I'm singing, they will just bring forth the body. Yeah. Move in this place. Everybody stand. Everybody stand. Move in this place today. This is my one desire, that you will have your way. Touch me, Lord, and I won't be the same. Move in this place today. Move in this place today. This is my one desire, that you will have your way. Touch me, Lord, and I will be the same. Move in this place today. Yes, one more time. Move in this place today. This is my one desire, that you will have your way. One more time, move in this place today. This is my one desire, that you will have your way. Touch me, Lord, and I will be there. We're going to call Prophetess Agnes C. George, who will open up in prayer.
Father, we thank you. We thank you this morning, for your grace is sufficient and your strength is made perfect. Father, we thank you, God, for your people at assembly here together. We thank you for the two lives that have been laid before us. We know, God, that you are in control. We thank you for everyone that gathered this morning, that you will keep us in your perfect will. Give us the strength to cope with everything. Because, Father, we don't have the strength this morning, but your strength is made perfect in all of our weaknesses. You said, God, that you will be our refuge and our fortress. And I bring, oh God, everyone that gathered here today, the mother, father, sisters, brother, niece, nephews, a son, daughter-in-law, everyone we bring before you. I pray that you will come and sit among us and hold us with your powerful hands. Because you are the creator, my God. You're not in pain. that so many of us going through today. But we still believe you, because we know that you are the boss and you know us best. But I pray you will comfort every heart this morning. Comfort us and hold us with your powerful hands. And Father, I thank you right now that you will have your way. Bless us, God. As Moses and Dianne lay before us this morning, we pray your mighty hands, God, we're still, God. As you said, to be absent from this body is to be present with you. And God, I pray, God, that you will touch every life today and give us the strength, even when this is over and we leave to go home, you will be a sword and a shield, a strong tower. You will lead us and direct us. And Father, we thank you today for all that you have deposited in us. We will not be weary. We are not tired, because you know us best. And Father, we thank you right now. And we give you praise and we commit everything into your hands. And we ask you to have your divine way. In Jesus' name.
This is the air I breathe. This is the air I breathe. Your holy presence living in me. Without you, oh God. desperate for you. I'm lost without you. I'm desperate for you. I'm desperate for you. When peace and light are ever contend with my will, when sorrows like deep
soul dancing. For the eulogy by Julian, Joel, and Isaac.
Check one, two.
This is difficult for us to do. Dianne Henry, formerly Ram Ratan, was born on the 4th of January, 1965. She was the third of four blessings bestowed to Isaac and Judy Ram Ratan from God. She was considered the baby of the family until 14 years later. The real baby came into the picture. And we all know that back then she wasn't too pleased. Mom and Dad, as well as her siblings, Robin, Jenny, and I, loved her very much. Dianne and I shared lots of memories together, from choosing the latest fashions, exchanging ideas, words of wisdom, advice, and so much more. Dianne was the quietest, most loving, caring, compassionate person anyone could have met. Some of our fondest memories are our countless trips to Guaya, to her beach house, which she loved. We would cook all our favorite dishes that we would never get to eat at home, and she would make her special drink, swank, commonly known as lime juice. I would never forget sleeping out in the beach house and wondering who snored harder, Moses or Dianne. Maybe it was a tie. Moses was the original corn curls fisherman and also the king of wickedness. Just ask Stacy. My sister was a strong, God-fearing person, praying always, never ceasing. Just like her commitment to her family, she was dedicated to God and her church. She planted a seed that pushed me to turn my life to God. Dianne, I thank you for always being there for me and my children when I was in need. I miss you dearly. Take care, and I will see you on the other side.
Hi, morning, everyone. Today, I pay tribute to the man I considered a hero. The man who taught me many life lessons, which I would now take with me in this new chapter of my life. I am the elder of my parents' two sons. Amongst the many traits my father possessed, I mostly admired the fact that he was a hard worker. He was a well-respected man in our community. From a young age, he taught us how to give, as he was very charitable and showed us not to hesitate in giving. Over the years, he helped and encouraged a number of persons in business, as he was always passionate about having your own business. One of the many ways he earned respect was by being a teacher. He always had a lesson to be taught or advice to give. Everyone around him benefited from his company. He was famous for his old-time sayings, some of which stuck with me are, eat little and live long. Don't hang your hat where you can't reach it. Patient man, ride donkey, and drink his coffee cold. Through his actions and the way he spoke about us, everyone knew how much he loved his children. He worked hard and always tried his best to give us anything he could afford. Daddy would always put aside anything he was doing to help us find a solution to any problem we had. My father built his business from the ground up and was able to teach me many business lessons and strategies which will continue to help me for the rest of my life. I know he was proud of my accomplishments, and I find comfort in knowing that he is smiling down on me. As I reflect, I've realized how proud I am of him and how much I valued his approval. I cannot begin to imagine not having a dad. On the end of every phone call, or popping around at a moment's notice to assist. I will forever remember having the most incredible father. I hope one day to be a great father. And a great man just like him.
Morning, everybody. First and foremost, I just want to say thanks to everybody for coming out. On behalf of me and my family, and I thought I would have been in a position like this, to be honest. But one thing I do remember about my parents is that if I try to summarize the entire life, it would be probably like about 10 books and more. So this is me trying to summarize as best as I could. On the 11th of December 1982, my mom was just 17 years old when my father took her hand in marriage. They began their journey together on his birthday on December 4th, 1983. My parents welcomed their firstborn, Joel Thaddeus Henry. And 7 years later, I was born, Isaac Emmanuel Henry. The best memory I have of my mom is hard to choose. Still, it was a lot. However, I remember the time we spent in New York as a family. It's proved to be the best. As for that, one of the best moments I would cherish is when we would take off for drugs on a Sunday. His life was cars, especially fast ones. For this memory, shared with both my parents, this is when we dined out at different family restaurants. Through a good meal and conversation, we bonded clearly, closely, speaking about each other's lives and experiences, anything that may affect us. My parents instilled in Joel and I a God-fearing life. They left a legacy which would remain in with us and carry on for the rest of our lives. Mom and Dad insisted that we pray together each morning, as they always said, a family that prays together stays together. Surely this will be imparted to our children and our children's children. So I love you both, Mom and Dad, Mrs. Diane and Moses Henry, till we meet again.
If there is anybody in the congregation that would like to come and just say a few words on behalf of Moses and Dianne, if there is anybody that would like to come and share their love and their sympathy for them.
Two. I must first say good morning and greetings in the wonderful name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. I thank God for this occasion whereby we can come together so that to celebrate the death of my brother Moses and his wife Dianne. I thank God for the years that we spend in fellowship one with another, knowing that God, our Savior, has brought us out of darkness into this light that shine upon us, which is Jesus Christ. I tell you, Moses is two brothers younger than me. I thank God for his upbringing. He learned a trade with me, which is straightening and painting. And you know, just not a trade, but also I was, in charge of his life, trying to help him to lead an upright life. And I tell you, over the years that we have been together, I tell you, Satan tried to separate us with disagreement. But listen, that didn't last. We trust God, and he restored our friendship, our fellowship, and our relationship so that we can live in good terms and be a good example to our children. I want to let you know that, listen, all the years of our lives, our parents brought us up. And he carried us on a bicycle, towing us to go to Sunday school. But the police passed and they stopped him. And they lock him up. They throw the bike in the jeep. And listen, we have to walk. But nevertheless, when they let him go, he began to ride again and still come and pick us up. This is the example and the training that we got, and many more, but time will not permit for me to tell you. But I thank God for his family. Whenever things go wrong, we always come together and we will pray with one another that God will bring a release upon us and a blessing. I thank God for my two nephews, Joel and also Isaac, whom God has renewed in the spirit of his mind, in the spirit of their mind. I want to tell you that, listen, a turning point has come for these two to trust God for all that they are in need of. The example was set by his father and many of us. I pray in Jesus' name that they will continue to focus on Jesus, who is the author and finisher of their faith, and that they will not be afraid, neither will they be dismayed. For the Lord thy God is with you, Joel and Isaac, to strengthen you. And he promised that no weapon formed against you shall prosper, and any tongue that rise up against you in judgment, he will condemn. The blessings of the Lord our God be upon you too, and the rest of your family. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thank you.
Good day, everyone. My condolences goes out to the family of Dianne and the family of Moses. Joel, I've never find a task as hard as this. First time I'm accustomed in front of a crowd. Crowd is small. But this morning, my heart went to library, run a marathon, and was heading to Blanchard's. And when I saw the hearse, my head hurt, I needed a toilet, and everything else. And I said, why Joel do me this? I was asked to say something about someone. She's not my friend. She's neither my best friend. She's my sister. And my sister for years. And I was thinking how to describe my sister. My sister was a very independent, determined, with a streak of stubbornness person. Independent in the sense she likes to know that she can do something for herself and to achieve something for herself. And down to the ages, coming down to this time, I remember talking with her and I said, Dianne, how about a Wednesday meal? And you start selling. I said, you can cook. How about a Wednesday meal? Dianne took up the challenge and she continued doing it. Dianne was loved, greatly loved by the community. Then I turned and I said, Dianne, what about a Saturday night snack, burger and fries? And she said, yes. She started it, but she couldn't continue. Her feet hurt so bad. So bad. She couldn't continue it. But still, she never gave up that Wednesday meal. And every Wednesday evening, I'll say how it went. She said it was okay, you know what? I said, well, that's business. You go up, you go down with business. Stick with it, and one day God will bless you. Determined person. Once she set her mind on a goal, she's going to go after it. You cannot talk her out of it. She's going to go after it. And if you try to talk her out of it, she will stay very quiet. But she go in. Very determined. She was a gentle, soft, soothing, nice person. I was the miserable one between the both of us. I will never forget her laugh. My nickname for her was Chiny. We would do a lot of things together, go out together, and everywhere we go, I don't know, for some reason, people will ask, are you sisters? And the first time that was asked, she look at me, I look at her, and we say yes. And the person asked, how you are sister? I said, because she take all the Chinese, the French, and the Spanish, and the Indian. I take all the Indian part. And that was fun for us. We like to do people those things. She determined in the sense that she hate one to come to church and song service begin. It's going on. Mm-mm. That's not Dianne. She must be in church before song service. If she reach during song service going on, she said that is not church. She was a passionate person. A person who loved to deliver, to help people. During this coronavirus 2 years business, Dianne helped a lot of people. She was not the type to broadcast or say what she do. She always believed in doing things in a closet. She was a down-low person. But I know that her family would know what she's doing. She would let them know. Dianne was the type of person who will worry because she know her parents will worry about her. That was her biggest worry. Dianne was also passionate in giving to others, even if it means taken from her own kitchen and to help. A plate of food to a stranger was nothing big to Dianne. She was a person who loved her family, her parents. She will do anything for her parents. That family, I always admire the bond in that family. I knew when Robin was sick, his wife was sick. I heard the whole story. I know when she's going by her mother. I know when she's going in the market to get things for her mother. I know all what she did for her family. She never put her family out. She loved them with a passion. She loved them with grace. She loved her children. Only God knows. I can't explain it. There are prayers that are banked up in the banks of heaven for the both of you. And I can't say both of you now. I have to say four of you. And those prayers will be coming down. It's never-ending prayers. She was a spiritual person. She believed in prayer. She was a warrior. Streak of stubbornness. I'll give you an example. Going through something, and we were talking about her and Moses. And I called her one day. I said, listen to me. You are not me. Me, not you. I want to listen to what I have to say. And after this, I have nothing more to tell you. We had a conversation, and that was it. She didn't call me back. The next day, she called me. She said, you listen to me now. I am not going to do it. Do not ask me to do it. And that's the end of the conversation. I know not to bring up that again. Her no meant, don't ask me again. I remember when Matthew was in hospital. That was my sole strength. She and Moses. I cannot explain the connection that couple had with our home. Unconditional love. Not a day passed that they did not want to know what Matthew was going on with Matthew. There was a time Richard Crystal worked the morning and came home the next morning. Going to sleep to get up to go to work that evening. And all of a sudden I see her running my room dressed. What happened? Uncle Moses just called me a going. That was what it was like. With that couple, their family and our family. A bond that nobody could explain. Hence the reason why I could say she was not my best friend. She was my sister. I will always remember them. I remember Moses. I will call Moses and say, you're home? Yes, I'm coming. And his hands would be like this, holding close, with a leg up. And when he see me coming, he just start to jiggle. Talk to me. What happened? Talk to me. His favorite line. I say, all I want to do is I want a hug. She said, you leave home to come to... I said, yeah, I want a hug. So he would give me the hug, and then he said, let him go. I said, did I tell you to let go? A guy was there, I didn't know the guy running me. I ain't want to be in no trouble. And he ran. I remember Moses. And when I passed, he said, there's something on the counter there for you. There was this guy who would pass with a wheelbarrow. And to everything he buy for Dianne, he would buy for me. So he will buy two bundles of actual, two bundles of body, one for Dianne, one for me. And all Dianne will do is just jiggle and laugh. We had some good times together. I thank God that memories do not live like men do. I choose to allow the good memories of Dianne to remain with me. I thank God that before Moses entered into that ambulance, Crystal allowed me to talk to him. And we had a conversation. I said, come back. I'm waiting on you. In the hospital, I spoke with him. His voice was strong, powerful. Moses was Moses. But on Tuesday, God had another plan. On Wednesday, I went to Dianne. I hugged her. I played with her hair. I talked to her. Need to be strong. I need you. I'm ready to let you go. You ain't going nowhere. She told me a couple things. The Thursday, I went back. The day Crystal and Richard was taken her to the hospital, Crystal allowed a video call with me and Dianne. In spite of her grief, in spite of her pain, in spite of whatever she was going through, Dianne had that smile on her face. Dianne was a fighter, and I told Dianne, fight it. We're going to pray for you like we did it for Matthew. She was transferred to Cuba. And for that 2 weeks, the house wasn't the same. My children had a second mother in hospital, and they couldn't do nothing to her. My children, second father was gone. Nobody. Until the day Dianne closed her eyes. But you know what? Knowing the PowerPoint she is, I know Dianne went with a fight. I know that Dianne went down praying, and one day our favorite line being, this too shall pass. When the roll is called up yonder and God put in his appearance, I will see my beloved brother and my cherished sister. At the moment, there's a big hole. They say time will fill it. I don't know. But those two people, they say, things come to you one time, one in a million years. That is the one that is in that casket. Both of them. It will never have a next one like the both of them. Yeah, they were there for us as a family. They stood by our side and they never let us go. One day, Crystal Matthew, Richard, Linda, Joel, Isaac, Kemba. One day I will see my sister. One day.
I love you, Lord, for your mercy never fails me all my days. I've been held in your hand from the moment that I wake up until I lay my head. I will of the goodness of God. All my life you have been faithful. All my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I can breathe,
to the podium, Pastor Ben.
Well, praise the Lord, everybody. Good morning, everybody. It's so good to be in the house of the Lord this morning. Amen. This morning, we are here for the homegoing service of our two beloved brethren, Sister Dianne and Brother Moses. Amen. Two wonderful people in Jesus' Lamb, you know. It's two people that we love. Amen. They have gone too soon, a little too soon, amen? But we thank God that in Christ Jesus, it is hope, amen? Amen? So I'm going to say good morning to Prophetess Agnes St. George. She's here. I'm filling in for Bishop. Bishop could not have been here this morning due to circumstances, amen? But thank God that you are here, I am here, amen? So, a homegoing service here at Jesus Elam, when one of our brethren passed on, we call it homegoing because we know where they are going and who they are going to meet. Amen? And these two brethren is two lovely brethren, you know, and we will soon, very, very, very soon, I already don't miss Brother Moses. Amen? You know, he's a good brother. He used to always come to me and say, keyboard man. That's what he used to tell me, keyboard man. You know, and he, wonderful brother, brilliant, wonderful brother. And let me say unto you, every one of you who are here this morning, it is possible that you're going to see Sister Dianne and Brother Moses again. It is quite possible that you're going to see them. But you have to do one thing. If you want to see them, you have to do one thing. You got to live right. You got to live good. You got to live right. If you live good and live right, you're not going to see them. Amen. The hope is there. Amen. There's hope. Amen. When our Lord returns, you're going to see them. Amen. What is lying in these two coffins here before us is the house that they have lived in on this earth. If you're living on this earth, you have to get a body to live in. Amen? But that's not the real you. What we're seeing here in the coffin is not the real Dianne and the real Moses. Amen? They're not here. The Bible tells me absent from the body is present with the Lord. They are with the Lord in paradise right now. Amen? What is before us here is the house that they lives in on the earth. Everybody who comes to the earth to live have to get a body to live in. Amen? So that's just the house that they were living in. Amen? The house get damaged or it break down and they couldn't live in that house anymore. So what they did, they came out and go back original. That's what they did. They came out of that house. They couldn't live in it anymore. And they go back original. Amen, my brethren? When God made us as human beings, God did not make funeral. When God made Adam and Eve, he didn't make no funeral. He didn't say, this is your funeral date. God didn't do that. Amen? Funeral comes about because we have an enemy out there who don't love us. Amen? His name is Lucifer. We call him Satan. He don't love us. Amen? He is the author of all kind of sickness and disease and evil. Amen? And death. He is the one that bring it on us as human being. Amen? So, God sent forth Jesus, another Adam, who redeem us from that. Amen, my brethren? Praise the name of the Lord. This morning, I'm not going to preach to you. I just want to speak to your heart. You know, it's so thrilling to see, you know, our brethren leaving this earth, you know, and then going before the time. Some people might say, well, it was their time and they had to go. That's not true. Amen? The devil could take you out. Amen? I almost died from the same disease. Amen? I spent the whole of November in the Coover, Mount Hope, and Arima Hospital. Right there. As you see me, I spent that whole month suffering with that same sickness that they got. Amen? And I fight it off by the power of the word of God. Amen? I fight it off. No doctor, medicine, didn't heal that. It's the power and the word of God. Amen. And I fight it off. And it had was to leave me. Amen. Otherwise, I might have been underneath the earth today. Praise the name of the Lord God. Amen. But God is good. Some of us, you know, the Bible tells us every one of us have an appointed time. Amen. The Bible says it's appointed unto man once to die. And after that comes judgment. Amen. So you got to be careful how you live. You got to be careful out there in this world today. The world right now, nobody knows what to do. The world is confusing right now. Nobody knows what to do. Amen. Because of this dreadful plague that come upon the earth. Amen. Scientists and doctors and everybody have no answer. Praise the name of the Lord God. Amen. But Jesus have the answer. And what you have to do is to give over your whole life to Jesus. Live for him. Amen. And he promised to protect you and guide you. And he said, no good thing will he withhold from them that walk uprightly. So family members, I'm so sorry that these two brethren, wonderful brethren, had to go. I'm very, very, very thrilled in my heart that they had to go. I'm so sorry. But there is hope that you're going to see them again. Amen? And you're going to live right. You're going to live good. Amen? Now, when I was told I have to minister to you this morning, ask the Lord what to say to you, and the Lord told me to ask you a question. The Lord told me to ask you a question. And the question is, what if the next homegoing service is yours? Are you prepared? Are you ready to meet the Lord? I'm not saying that to get you frightened. But if the next homegoing service is yours, are you prepared and ready to meet the Lord God? Because when you see you come out your body, you're meeting up with the Lord, you know. And Jesus is the way to heaven. Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. Jesus is the gateway to heaven. When you come out your body, you meet with him in the next world. And if you're not prepared, sadness is going to be your portion. Amen. So the Lord wants me to ask you this question. Are you prepared to meet Jesus? Are you ready to go to heaven? Are you ready to meet the Lord God? If the next homegoing service is yours, are you ready? I just want to read a scripture here. In the book of Thessalonians 4, the Bible tells me, for the Lord himself will descend from heaven with a shout and with the voice of the archangel, and the dead in Christ will rise. Let me say that in a little slow motion here for you. The dead in Christ. The dead in Christ will rise first and caught up together with those who are in Christ alive to meet the Lord in the air. And the Bible says we shall be with him forever. Amen. You know what is going to happen one of these days? Amen. The Bible, that scripture, just read it. You know what is going to happen one of these days? One of these days, the jumbo jet will be flying to New York and England and Europe, and the captain disappear. The TNT Express and TNT Spirit will be sailing to Trinidad and Tobago, and the captain disappear. The maxi driver will be driving into Port of Spain on the priority and disappear on all the passengers. People will get up in the morning and miss mommy, miss daddy. Oh, my God. You will come to the church and realize today's Sunday and no church going on. What is happening here? One of these days, it's going to happen. Jesus is not going to stay and look at what's going on this world. His coming is very close. Very close. He said, when you see these things, I am close. And brethren, you got to make it right. Amen. You got to make it right with Jesus. Amen. You got to make him, make your heart, give him over, walk in love, one to another. Amen. So Jesus is going to appear, and the Bible said, the dead in Christ will rise first. One of the days when he come back, the burial ground is going to look like if a backhoe dig it up. We're going to rent up in pieces. All the bones will come back together and flesh will return to the bone. The Bible says this mortal body, the reason why we die is because our body is mortal. Our body is subject to sickness and disease. Our body could a gun or something sharp, something, a stone or something could destroy. Our body could destroy because it is mortal. But the Bible says this mortal will put on immortality. When you're immortal, you cannot die. You don't need doors, you don't need plane, you don't need cars. Amen. If you want to go downstairs and walk through the floor and go downstairs, that's when you're immortal. One of these days, Jesus is going to raise back our body. Dianne and Moses is going to get back a new body. Amen. And they're going to be resurrected on that great day when the trumpet sung. Amen. And they're going to caught up with you and me. And we all going to live together with Jesus for eternity. Oh, my God. You see, when God made Adam in the beginning, he made Adam to live for eternity. There was no death. Death come about because Adam disobeyed God. Amen. In Romans 6 and verse 23, the Bible said, for the wages of sin is death. That's why we die. Sin make we die. The wages. Wages is payment. Amen. So when people sin and go around and doing evil, it's a job they're doing, and the payment is death. The wages of sin is death. My God. But the gift of God is eternal life through our Lord Jesus Christ. So, brethren, you got to live good. You got to live right. Amen. There was an incident that took place in John 11 where Lazarus, a good friend of Jesus, had died. Lazarus. Some of you might hear about that story. Lazarus died. But before he died, the message went to Jesus. And they said to Jesus, your friend Lazarus is sick. And Jesus didn't go nowhere. He stayed where he was. He didn't go nowhere. And Lazarus died. And they buried him. And 4 days later, Jesus showed up. Yes, Jesus showed up at Lazarus' home. And when his sister saw him, she went to him and she said, Lord, if you were here, my brother would not have died. And Jesus looked at her. And Jesus just marveled. And Jesus said to her, he will live again. And she said to him, yes, I know he will live again in the resurrection that is to come. And you know what? She activated Jesus one time. Jesus said to her, I am the resurrection and the life. Oh, my God. Look me here standing in person in front of you. That's what Jesus was saying to her. Look me standing up in front of you. I am the resurrection and the life. He said, he that believeth on me, though he were dead, yet shall he live. And watch this verse, John 11, verse 26. I just call this the golden text of the Bible. John 11, verse 26. It says, he that liveth and believeth on me will never die. You could read it when I go home. Praise the name of the Lord. He that liveth and believeth on me will never die. Brethren, when you have Jesus in your heart, when you're serving him, when you're living for him, you don't die. Just like Sister Dianne and Brother Moses, they're not really dead. They just change address. They just change their address, even, and go back original. They go back in their natural form. Praise the name of the Lord God. So, brethren, when Jesus told them that, Jesus said, he that liveth and believeth on me will never die. Mary them couldn't believe that. And Jesus groaning in spirit. And he said to them, show me where you lay him. Martha said to him, Lord, he already dead 4 days. He's stinking now. Read it in the Bible. He's stinking now. He already dead 4 days. And Jesus groaned. And in verse 35, you ever read the shortest verse in the Bible? Anybody ever read the shortest verse in the Bible? Jesus wept. Jesus cried in verse 35. What did he cry for? Not because Lazarus died. He cried because they didn't quite believe what he told them and because of his love that he had for them. So Jesus went, show me where he lived. And he went over to the tomb where Lazarus was laid. And he told them, move that stone that you have in front of the tomb. And the Bible said, he called with a loud voice, Lazarus, come forth. And the Bible says that Lazarus came out the very same way that they lay him wrapped up in the sheet or whatever. He came out and he tell them, loose him and set him free. Brethren, there is hope, but it is in Jesus. You have to have Jesus if you to have that hope, that eternal life. You have to. There was another incident when Jesus was walking to a city. And while he was walking to the city, they were bringing out a dead man in a coffin. And Jesus said to them, put it down on the ground. Put it down. Jesus is the only man that I know ever stopped a funeral. He said, put it down. And when they put it down, he opened it. And he said, young man, arise. And the young man that was dead came back alive on that city. Brethren, so all our hope, it is in Jesus. Amen. Family members, build your hope, love one another, live in peace with each other, be there for each other, serve God. Now is the time that you're supposed to serve God. Amen. Jesus said, he's not willing that any one of us should perish, but that all of us should come to repentance. Amen. He's not willing. That's why he come to the earth. Jesus is the Almighty. Amen. He came to the earth to redeem us, to save us. Amen. And just imagine he has all the power. And he came like a human being to save us. That's why. One man said to me the other day, if God is who God is, why God didn't wipe out all the evil and the devil and everybody? I said, no, sir. God cannot do that. Why? I said, well, God is a just God. He is just God. He can't just stop the devil from tempting you or trying you. He can't just stop everything. Otherwise, the devil will go into his face and say, why you do that? Why you do that? So, brethren, live for God and everything is going to be okay. Amen? So, back to the question. What if the next homegoing service is yours? Are you prepared to meet the Lord? Are you ready? I want you to bow your heads with me and study, check your heart, check yourself. To live without Jesus Christ, I believe, is the most dangerous thing on this earth, to live without Jesus as your personal Savior. I accept him in my life 45 years ago and never turned back. Praise the name of the Lord. If you have never made Jesus Lord and Savior of your life, and you want to do it today, you want to do it now, you could do it right now. I'm not telling you to come and join Jesus Elam Church. I'm just telling you to make Jesus Lord and Savior of your life. Some people didn't do it. One time, I was talking to a gentleman, he was 78 years old, and he told me he didn't do that yet. Never did that. And he did it. Praise the name of the Lord God. So if you want to do it, just repeat this prayer after me. Say, Lord Jesus, I come before you now. I believe you came and died and risen from the dead. And from this day forward, I make you Lord of my life. come into my heart, Lord Jesus. I want to live for you for the rest of my life. Now thank you for forgiving me for all that I've done wrong. And thank you for saving me in Jesus' name. Now if you just say that prayer, you know what happened? In heaven, the sheet that was by your name, they fold it up and threw it in the bin and put a clean one by your name. If you really say that prayer and mean it, angels in heaven rejoicing right now. Some of them will be telling the Lord God, send me to God him, send me to God she, because that's what the angels of the Lord does. They encamper round about them that fear God. Amen. Praise the name of the Lord. So before I commit the bodies of our two brethren, I want to do what we normally does here at Jesus Elam. Right? So what I want us to do right now, I want all the family members to just come right on this side of the altars, please. All the family members come right on the side of the altar. We want to say a special prayer for you, every one of you. Praise the name of the Lord God. Blessed be the name of the Lord God. Right? Thank you for coming. Right now, this is anointed oil. Okay? Now, keep a social distance, right? But this is a anointed oil. It's not no ovia or nothing. I just want you to take a little and rub it on your forehead. And if you're suffering with any sickness or disease, anything that wrong, believe God with me now. I want to say a special word of prayer for you right now. All right? Praise his holy name. Just take a little and rub it on your forehead. Or you could just rub it in your hand. Okay? All right, and the rest of you, believe God with us right now. All right? Let us just enter into the presence of our Lord. Father God, in the name of Jesus, I bring these family members of our beloved brother and sister before you, God. I know you are mighty God. With you, nothing is impossible. I ask right now, God, that you, oh God, open up the windows of heaven. Shower your mighty blessings upon every one of them in the name of Jesus. I declare from this day forward, oh God, that they shall be on top and not beneath. I declare that they shall be the lender, not the borrower. I declare that no weapons that form against them shall prosper. Every tongue that rise up against them, I condemn it in the name of Jesus. I declare right now, God, that they shall have the victory over every circumstances and difficulties. I declare right now, God, that every muscle, every joint, every tissue, every cell, every organ in their body will work the way you design it in the name of Jesus. I rebuke every other sickness and disease that will try to come upon them. I destroy it right now in the name of Jesus. And I declare that they shall be winners and overcomers in every area of their life, oh God. And I thank you for receiving them. Oh God, replace their mourning with joy right now. You said weeping do enjoy it for a night, but joy cometh in the morning. Oh God, just replace their mourning with joy in the name of Jesus. And I give you thanks and praise for doing it in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. What I want you all to do, well, I know you cannot hug each other, right? So I just want you to give each one a little high five, and I want you all to live together in peace. Amen? Live together in unity among you all self. Amen? So what you could do right now, just give one a little high five, and then you could go back to your seats, okay? Our elbow. Praise the name. Praise the name of the Lord. praise his holy name. Okay. Just before I commit the body of our beloved sister, I want to read a couple of scriptures just before I commit the body of our beloved sister and brother. Amen. Everyone could stand with me right now. Could you all stand with me? The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. He made me to lie down in green pastures. He led me beside the still waters. He restored my soul. He led me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, do I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou hast prepared a table before me in the presence of my enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil. My cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the strength of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid? When the wicked, even my enemies and my folk, come upon me to eat of my flesh, they stumble and fell. Though an host shall encamp against me, I shall not fear. Though war shall rise against me, in this will I be confident. One thing I have declared or desire of the Lord, that I shall seek after, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life. Where is his holy name? Jesus was speaking one time and he said, fear not, I am the first and the last. I am he that liveth and was dead, and behold, I'm alive forevermore. Because I live, you shall also live. Behold, I show you a mystery. We shall not all sleep, but we shall be changed in the moment, in the twinkling of an eye, at the last trump. For the trump shall sound, and the dead shall raise incorruptible, and we shall be changed. For this corruptible must put on incorruption, and this mortal must put on immortality. So when this corruptible shall have put on incorruption, and this mortal shall have put on immortality, then shall it brought to pass the saying, as it is written, death is swallowed up in victory. O death, where is thy sting? O grave, where is thy victory? For the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, and with the voice of the archangel, and with the trump of God, and the dead in Christ shall rise first. Then we which are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the cloud to meet the Lord in the air. And so shall we ever be with the Lord God. Ladies and gentlemen, Dianne and Moses is not here with us today. What is lying before us is the house that they have lived in, or the body as we know it, that they're living on the face of this earth. And we look forward at the day when the body is going to renew night with their spirit. Amen. So Heavenly Father, we thank you on this day for Jesus, for the precious gift of life and eternal life, and for the comfort of the Holy Spirit in the midst of our natural sorrow. We thank you for the supernatural grace in facing death. We thank you for the promise of everlasting life. And in the face of separation, we thank you for the assurance of eternal reunion of body and spirit. So on this very day, the 9th of February, 2022, we commit the body of Dianne Henry and Moses Henry back to the earth from whence it came, whence it shall return, dust to dust, ashes to ashes, earth to earth, in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. My Father God, we thank you for receiving, O God, Dianne's body and Moses' body. We thank you, God, because you are God. With you, nothing is impossible. You created us and you could do anything. So we thank you and we wait for the day when they will reunite with their body and we shall all be gathered in happiness and joy that will fill our soul. May they rest in peace right now in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Praise his holy name. Could all of us say this prayer together? Our Father which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those that trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from all evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen and amen. Okay, brethren, there's not going to be any viewing of the body. All right? There's not going to be any viewing of the body. So we ask right now that you have a very good day, a very wonderful time, a very day. And those of you, I pray that the Lord God will, you know, restore your morning with joy. And those of you, you know, let it be happiness. You're going to see Dianne and Moses again. Just live right, live good. And you definitely are going to see them again. Amen. God richly bless every one of you. And thank you for coming out today. Praise the name of the Lord God.